Smile Makers Trainings, we are well happy to give you smile tips. So today I just want to ask a question to Ramya. Okay. Ramya, tell me, you are living separately from your parents. Does your mother talk to you every day? Does she?
Yeah, every day.
Yeah. And what are the questions that she asks you? What are the main... she asks you about your food. And why do you think she asks you the same question every day? And how do you feel when she keeps asking you the same question every day? What is your food? How are you eating? You know, especially for people who are young, unmarried people who are staying away from their parents, you know, they keep asking, what do you eat? So why do you think she asks you that?
Because here we have to prepare ourselves, no? So she may be thinking that.
I know. So what she may be thinking? Little louder.
She may be thinking that I will be not having because I have to cook, you know. So
yeah, so having. Correct. So, you know, when somebody asks you the same question again and again, there is a chance that you might get irritated. Right? Why every day she's asking the same thing again and again? But remember, okay, if you look at it even more deeper, you will understand that you also need to think of it from her viewpoint. And you'll realize that she is basically very concerned about you. It is her love and her care that is making her ask you again and again. When your mother calls you and asks you, especially those who are lucky enough to have still their mothers around, you know, they are just concerned about your health, they're concerned about your well-being. And if you can listen to the care, then you will not get irritated about that repeated question day after day. So today I'm going to introduce the concept of empathy. Everybody knows what is empathy. Empathy is not sympathy. Sympathy is when you feel sorry for somebody, that is sympathy. So what is empathy? Empathy is your ability to feel what the other person is feeling. So if you really want to connect with people, one of the qualities which you'd really be happy to develop is the quality of empathy. And this is bring empathy to the way in which you listen to people. So I'm actually introducing the concept of empathetic listening. So next time somebody talks to you, don't just listen to the words what they're saying. Don't just hear the words what they're saying. Don't just pay attention and listen to the words. A higher level than attentive listening is called empathetic listening, where you make an attempt to understand what is the feeling of the words behind that. Make an understand to feel what the other person is feeling. You know, one day my husband suddenly called me from one course he was doing. And he says, you know what, I was always proud of myself for being a good listener. But, you know, today I understood that, you know, I really feel when I was sitting at home and I keep grumbling about something or the other, you know, he says, I can feel what you're going through. And I understand what you're going through. So you also try to do that with people around you, okay? Especially when somebody is grumbling or somebody is expressing some kind of things. Even people who are criticizing you, you know, maybe they are going through their own personal turmoil. Maybe they are not at peace with them mentally. They are not mentally at peace with themselves. That is why they have to take it out on somebody, so you become the punching bag. You know, you don't know what are the reason why people behave the way they behave. Okay? But if you can just try to feel what they are feeling, I think you'll be in a calmer state of mind and you'll be able to understand people better and you'll have a better connection with them. Okay? Simple smile tip for the day. Practice empathetic listening. Make sense? Thank you.